coming up next, a UFC lightweight division bout.
So here we go with round one. Seems to be a throwback type of matchup here. The classically trained striker taking on the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. But BJJ black belt with this guy doesn't even begin to describe his credentials.
It does not describe how good he is. His vast knowledge of all the Jiu-Jitsu positions. This guy, once you're on the ground, there is no place where you are safe. You are constantly getting attacked. He's always throwing up submissions. He's always attacking arms. He's always attacking your neck, doing everything to try and make you think submission's coming, even if it's just to change positions to secure top. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one? Barely missed on double cut right here on the inside.
All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shots that's incoming. Wow, actually got the takedown.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Well, you see all the grappling repetitions here. Just beautiful movement, seamless transitions on the ground.
Over and over, these guys are doing things that you see in every jiu-jitsu gym around the country.
All right, he continues to bully his opponent here, really manhandling him on the ground. And they both stand up. Oh, tagged him with that right hand. What a strike that was.
What a strike that he is landing over and over again. His opponent will need to make some adjustments.
Well, he's connecting on a few hooks so far here in the round, and there it is again. So every time he goes back to the well with that hook, he seems to find the target.
He does a great job of finding the placement on that shot. It is a great weapon to have. Big kick lands.
DC, didn't take him long to find his range here tonight, huh?
His timing is on point.
All right, so no surprise. Once again, we find ourselves here in this clinch situation. We'll see who can advance.
Who's gonna be the person to dictate the pressure? Who's gonna control the engagements from this 50-50 position?
Ready.
And we are underway. Well, if you are a young striker, you could do a lot worse than watching this guy work on the feet, perhaps trying to set up another hook here.
Yes, he is. He's definitely trying to set up another hook. You could tell by his eyes. He's taking peeks. He's sneaking looks at where he needs his opponent to be in order to land that shot.
Really timing his shots nicely. Good tempo, very accurate, finding the range with relative ease.
Yeah, he's doing a great job of really overwhelming his opponent with activity. Straight punch lands.
Bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night.
All right, side control now. We'll see if he can advance position. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control.
All right to the mount.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He is not pity-patting. He's not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel it.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Well, not good body language from his opponent here, DC. He's curled up.
No, he's exhausted. He's been beaten.
Both fighters get up now.
And now he's secured back position. There's no tell on that leg kick.
And both guys really throwing with authority. Oh, good opportunity to do damage here. He's got that tie clinch. Takedown attempt late in the round, and he gets it. All right, side control now. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
Close guard. Pretty good elbow there from the bottom as he continues to stay active off of his back. Overhand right, swing and a miss.
Big powerful punch lands. Now he gets back in range.
Second round, straight ahead. All right, so an entertaining 5 minutes. Let's look back at some of the highlights, DC, and I'd imagine a lot of these replays are going to be rooted in that kicking game that was on full display.
Absolutely. You're going to see a lot of different techniques, but the kicking was the key to him getting ahead in this fight. He's out ahead now. He needs to stay the course and continue to do that as the fight goes on.
Nice. That was perfect. Good round. He's rocked. He's still rocked, right? He's ready to be finished in this match, right?
Ready, fight? Ready.
All right, second round underway. Oh, and he lands a punch there. Good connection by him on that.
Great connect, so fast, so accurate. Watch the ability to land anywhere. I mean, look at the commitment to kicking in this fight.
Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of solid combinations here.
It's because he's not committing to it fully. He throws his jab. He may throw the right hand out there, but he's not really sitting down on the right hand. He really doesn't seem to have the intent on landing it. He's got to be confident that it's going to land, and he's got to really throw his whole entire body into those strikes. Oh!
So you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Oh, it looks like he's got him in a crucifix now, DC. A lot of body weight from the top position. How does he go about trying to finish this fight?
He just needs to stay heavy. He's got to keep his weight down. He's got to be working, but not working recklessly, because this is a position that you can escape. Make sure you secure your opponent, and make sure you secure your opponent. Land strikes that matter and end this fight.
Back to the feet now.
Look at the control of the posture as they land that knee. Nice punch there.
Muay Thai plump.
Oh, man, he's got his back against the side of the octagon. He needs to isolate a hip to try to peel those hands and break that lock.
All right, so he continues to use his jab effectively here, DC. He gets that hand to the target pretty quickly.
I mean, just right away, blasting the jab after jab after jab. He's a phenomenal boxer with a vast understanding of fighting behind an educated jab. Punch over the top.
Well, DC, headgear's not allowed, but he... Oh! Rewrack the highlight now, DC, and he's certainly going to enjoy watching this one back. The head kick was there early, it was there often, and ultimately ended the night for his opponent.
He found a weakness in his opponent's game. The left kick, over and over, he was able to land it. And he was landing strikes too with his hands, but ultimately it was the kick that was hidden behind the punch that finished the fight for him.
Now to Bruce Buffer for the official decision.
Call to stop this contest at 2 minutes, 20 seconds of round number two. Going the winner by knockout, Dynamite.
Oh, there he is after a huge knockout win tonight. You going to the after party or what?
I mean, I'm heading over there right now, John. I'm asking the producers, how soon can I get up? It's going to be a party over there. Not only because of the knockout, but that extra bonus check he's going to be carrying to the club tonight.